Ever wondered how computers are able to understand emotions in a given test? Don't worry, I used to wonder how computers are able to analyze a given tweet as positive, negative, or even neutral. In this tutorial, I'll take you through something we call sentiment analysis, which allows computers to be able to analyze a given test as positive, negative, or neutral. By the end of this tutorial, you will learn how to set up your environment to perform sentiment analysis. You also learn how to write the shortest code of your life. Trust me, the shortest code you've ever written to perform sentiment analysis. If you are ready, just grab yourself a cup of coffee and let's go through this tutorial together. And trust me, you will learn one or two things. Ready to do it? Let's get right into it.
All right, guys. So I've just fired up my Visual Studio Code and I will go ahead and bring up my terminal and install the libraries we'll be using for this particular tutorial. So the first library we'll be installing is NLTK. So just write pip install NLTK. NLTK is a Python library for processing natural language. So we use this particular library for whatever we are going to do today. Also, we install NumPy, which later on in this tutorial, I'll also use it to perform some mathematical stuff. So make sure if you are following along, you follow exact steps or you install these exact libraries. And if you have any problem, if you have any errors, don't worry, just put it in the comment section and I'll make it up to you. So I'll hit enter on this and I've gotten requirement already satisfied because I've already installed these libraries. In your case, it will just go ahead and install these libraries for you. Okay, so next thing I'll do is to create a new file, and you can name this file anything you want. I will just name it main.py in order to keep everything simple. Okay, so I'll go ahead and import NLTK. So just write import NLTK. Then from here, we'll also import NumPy. So let's import NumPy as np. Moving forward, we'll do from nltk.sentiment. Yeah, I think that's it. We are coming to import SentimentIntensityAnalyzer. My bad. So SentimentIntensityAnalyzer. And SentimentIntensityAnalyzer is a model in NLTK which helps you to perform sentiment analysis. Okay, so from here we'll do nltk.download, and this is a pre-trained model that helps you to do or that helps you to perform sentiment analysis. So this particular pre-trained model comes with the NLTK toolkit. So nltk.download here helps us to download that pre-trained model on our local machine to perform sentiment analysis. I'll go ahead and define a function and I'll call this function sentiment analysis. So I think this is quite good. And sentiment analysis will take in a text. Okay, moving forward, I just initialize the sentiment intensive analyzer. So I initialize it and giving it to a variable called SIA. All you need to do is to do SIA.polarity scores and give it your input test. So we are returning that from this particular function. Okay, so from here we can just use this function. So I'll say whatever we get or whatever we are returning to result, and I'll call the name of the function here called sentiment analysis and pass in this test. So I love this product. I think this is a positive sentiment test. There is no hate speech here. So I'll just go ahead and print result, and before I run this, I'll save it. So Control S, and I'll just give this a try. So let me run this. Boom, and we got our output. So I'll just ignore these three lines. I think we don't need it. All we need is this final output, which is a dictionary. So over here, let me just explain. So we have NEG, which stands for negative, and we have 0.0 scores for negative. Yes, that's because, if I should bring this down, that's because the given test here is a positive sentiment. And neutral, for neutral, we have 0.38, which is about 30% neutral. And I think, yeah, I love this product. Can be neutral some way, but it's much more positive than neutral. And for positive right here, you can see we have over 0.692. Okay, so this is about 69% positive. And compound here, so let me explain compound. Compound is a threshold between negative 1 and 1. And if you are in the positive range, that means the sentiment of your test is more positive than negative. So the threshold is between negative 1 and 1. So if you are in the negative threshold, that means you are your sentiment is negative. So let's try this. Let's change this love here with hate. I hate this product. Save and let's run so that you can see the compound value now. So over here, this is the second one, which is I hate this product, and you can see negative is 0.66%. Yes, it makes sense. This particular test is actually conveying a negative sentiment. Yes, a neutral is 0.33, so about 33% neutral. Positive is 0.00. This model is damn accurate. And for compound, you can see now we have 0.61% for compound, and this shows you how the compound works. So the compound is between negative 1 and 1, and if your test conveys some negative sentiments, I think your compound will be in the negative threshold. Alright, so this is how easy you can build a simple sentiment analyzer using this particular NLTK toolkit, and it's very easy, but I will continue on and I'll show you how you can also extract some of these tests. So since this is a dictionary, we can get the values and we can also get the names, so we can use it. So what I'll do is to say values. Let me call these values. Let me just make it a list of the result.values. So result.values, this will give us the values, which is the scores. Yeah, so it's a dictionary. And then we can also get the names, and the names is also equal to, we'll do list of result dot keys. So dictionaries have a dot key attribute which will give you all the keys. So the keys in our case is the negative, neutral, positive and compound. So if we should even print, let me just print names, and I also print values. Okay, I'll add a separation here. Sep is equal to, let's give it a new line as our separator. So yeah, let me clear off the terminal and let me run this and you see what we'll get. Okay, so we are able to, I think this is didn't work. Let me save this. Let me save this code. Clear the terminal once again and give this a try. Okay, so you can see we are able to extract the names, which is negative, neutral, positive and compound, and we are able to also extract the scores. So what we can do now is to use NumPy to associate the particular score with the name. Yeah, we just print, let's say what we'll print, it will be names, and inside names we'll do np.argmax for the value. So the argmax function takes in all these scores and we'll try to retain the higher score, so the score with the higher value, and we just print that. So if it's positive, we'll get positive. If it's negative, we'll get negative. I didn't save that, so let me save that. Clear the terminal and let me run this. So now we are expecting it to just return whether it's positive or negative, and we got some error. List object is not callable. That's line 18. Print names. Okay, so what we should have done here is to use square brackets. Let me save this and give it a try. So here we go. You just get a negative for whatever input test you have. So instead of getting all these scores, you can just get negative. Clear the terminal and run it once again, and you see we got negative. So you can see you can give it an any test at all, and then it will return to you if the sentiment in that test is negative or is positive, and you also have the compound as well, which tells you whether it's negative or positive. The range is between negative 1 and 1. So guys, this is all for this particular tutorial. This is an easy one, and I think it's an easy way to do sentiment analysis now using the NLTK toolkit. Let me know if you love it, and if you love it, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also share this with someone. If you have something bothering or some comments, leave them in the comment section and I'll do my best to answer them. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate you, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.